to the big story then. The Reserve Bank of India has constituted an expert panel to review its existing economic capital framework. The six-member panel will be chaired by former RBI Governor, Mr. Bimal Jalan. Lata Venkatesh joins us now with more details. Lata, good morning. Tell us what the constituents of this panel and what does this really mean?
Well, a couple of takeaways. One, that it looks like a very balanced panel. Dr. Bimal Jalan, former governor, been there, done that, knows what is the importance of having a strong central bank. Assisting him as vice chairman is Rakesh Mohan. Just recently wrote a three-part piece in the Business Standard, which appeared in the Business Standard, on the need to preserve central bank independence. So it's not someone, a committee of lightweights. It's a committee of people who have been there, done that. And then it seems balanced as well. And for an SC, Garg will argue for the government. You have an NSV, NS Vishwanathan, of RBI DG, who will argue for RBI. So it looks like it's reasonably balanced and will take care of all interests. The terms of reference are, I think, twofold. They are looking at the amount of profits that RBI shall transfer to the government every year after making provisions for its necessities, and the public policy as well as to look at the buffers that RBI sets aside for future contingencies. It will also look at the global best practices followed by other central banks and therefore look at even the past provisioning. It will look at the past reserves and see how much of it needs to be kept. So there is going to be a formula for the annual transfers as well as look at the accumulated earnings of the Reserve Bank. And most importantly, the committee gets 90 days from the date of its first meeting. When we requested Dr. Jalan yesterday, he said he hasn't yet got his letter. So, you know, after they get the letter, maybe today or tomorrow, then the committee meets. Looks unlikely they will meet this week because there are only 2 days left. So the meeting is sometime in the first week of January. 90 days from there would mean that it is unlikely that whatever money they speak about, the formula of reserves, will not be available to this government, but it will be available to future governments, series of governments, which is fair. The only point that people who are talking about the reserves were making is accumulated reserves of over 20 years should not go to just one government, which is going to the polls in 3 months. So that perhaps is taken care of by the manner of the constitution and the time given to the committee. My sense is the committee will evolve two formulae, one in terms of, you know, how to use the reserves, and one in terms of how the annual flow. So a stock and a flow will both be looked at. As well, I think, a sinking fund, so that in years when dividend is low, you dip into it. And, years when dividend is high, you keep aside a little. I would assume that formulae of all these kinds will be available. And this will not become an annual bickering point between the government and the RBI. That's the best we can hope.
All right. Thanks a lot for that, Lata. In fact, we also spoke with former Deputy Governor of the RBI, H.R. Khan, on what he makes of this development. Hear him out.
I think it's a fair, balanced composition. And both the chair and the vice chair are well-experienced economists who had been at the helm of affairs. And both of them understand RBI balance it very thoroughly. Since you're looking at a stock, we have to, of course, look at the global practices and also keep idiosyncratic issues of India. If something is accumulated over the period of time, you can't pass it in one shot to one particular government or one particular budget. So you have to have a dividend smoothening sort of a reserve once you have identified the excess. And over a period of time, you can transfer. If one part of the reserve is kept for financial stability issues. Yeah. And if there are really issues of the banking sector and there is a reform accompanying this recapitalization, identified part should go for that.
Well, moving on then, NBFC is likely to be in focus today. This after representatives from NBFCs and housing finance companies met Prime Minister Modi to discuss their concerns. Now, the industry leaders sought a liquidity credit line of 30 to 40,000 crore rupees from RBI as temporary relief. And Prime Minister Modi from his side assured them of necessary steps by the government to build confidence in credit market. Anu Sharma, a colleague, caught up with President of ASSOCHAM, BK Goenka, who was a part of this crucial meeting. Here's what he had to say on the key takeaways of this crucial meeting.
I think the major government has taken many proactive steps in last 3 months after the ILFS issues, and government is fully aware of the situation. What we are trying to bring it as a from the industry side, as SOCHM, is that how to bring the confidence back into the market. There is no liquidity crisis as such. It's a question of confidence and trust. And that is where the government has to announce certain measures. And I think if those measures are announced, which we have given the suggestion, I think we will see a change.
As per the meeting, what has been indicated by the Prime Minister to the industry body?
No, government, Prime Minister heard everybody's views from the housing finance company as well as the NBFCs. And he is very proactive and said going to look into the situation, what can be done.
So does ASSOCHAM fear that NBFCs or housing finance companies will default on their loans or mutual funds? Is there
no, I think that is not the fear. Right now the fear is how to keep the growth, the momentum on. The fear of default is already, government has taken many positive actions.
Right, with that, we'll sip into a short break. Come back. The government unveiled stricter rules for e-commerce players with FDI. More on that when we return.